Hello friends, today I'm going to show you the plants I brought from a local nursery and from a plant market. All these plants are quite hard to find in local nurseries. These plants need a lot of things to keep them happy and in shape. You can see my older plants which are very low in maintenance. So if you want to know more, then go to the link above. So, the first plant, as you can see, is a variety of rubber plant. This variety is known as Ficus elastica tinaki. You can see the plant is very big in size with a big pot with gorgeous leaf. The leaves are quite big in shape and the color of the leaves are also very great. You can see the foliage color is in cream, then there is some light green color, also some silver shades and also green color. Rubber plants are very slow growing plant. This plant have new leaves coming from the lower stem, you can see. All the varieties of rubber plant are very hardy, but they don't like their soil to be moist and also they don't like to be kept in direct sunlight. Water your rubber plant when the soil feels really very dry. You can see I did not change its soil till now. Normally this plant loves normal humidity. I will upload a soil mixture video near future. So the next variety in our row is a variety of Howarthia. This Howarthia is commonly known as zebra plant or zebra Howarthia, and its scientific name is Howarthia fasciata. This plant also cost me 100 rupees. You can see the leaves are quite thick and dark green in color with white horizontal stripes only on the outside of the leaves. This plant, or mainly the Howarthia variety, don't like to get direct sunlight. They love partial sun or shaded area. It need typical water like a succulent. You can see my another Howarthia species. This is known as Howarthia limifolia. You can see that it is doing very good in my house. In the previous Howarthia, there was a baby offset, and also you can see that in this Howarthia limifolia, there is also some baby offset, and also this plant is going to bloom very soon. So in my later video or in my future video, I will discuss about its care tips, its soil mixture and how to water your plant and what kind of sunlight your Howarthia needs. So now moving towards our some medium care plant. So you can see this is a variety of Peperomia. This variety is known as silver rippled Peperomia. This variety, or the rippled variety Peperomias, are also known as Peperomia caperata. These plants are native to Brazilian rainforest. Actually, these plant leaves are green in color, but they are so wrinkled that this appears in silver purple shades. This plant also cost me 100 rupees. Its soil mixture and care tips video is also soon coming in my future videos. So stay tuned to my channel. So the next variety is also a variety of Peperomia. This plant is known as Peperomia argyria, or commonly known as watermelon Peperomia or watermelon begonia. This plant is native to South America. You can see the leaves are in markings like a watermelon and the leaves are quite thick. This plant also cost me 100 rupees. This plant loves bright but indirect sunlight. Water this plant when the soil mixture is really very dry. So, moving towards our other plant, the next variety is a variety of philodendron. This variety is known as Philodendron Brazil or Philodendron Hedracium. This plant is also original from or native to South America. This is a fairly tolerant and attractive foliage plant. Philodendron are the easiest tropical plant to grow in your indoors. They can tolerate all kind of negligence like poor light quality, poor soil mixture, and also inconsistent watering. Soon I changed my all philodendron soil, so the soil mixture video is on its way to go. So stay tuned to my channel. So I also brought a variety of philodendron. This variety is commonly known as heartleaf philodendron. Its scientific name is Philodendron bipinnatum fidum. All the philodendrons belongs to Erica family. This philodendron original place or native place is also from South America. All the philodendrons love bright but indirect sunlight. They also love high humidity. So shower your plant time to time. And to make your plant thrive, just keep your soil very moist. So the next plant is also known as, you can see, this plant is also known as Hoya carnosa, otherwise also known as flax plant. You can see the leaves are quite like a succulent leaves. Its foliage is not that attractive, but its blooms are really very beautiful. It takes at least 3 to 4 years to bloom. This plant also cost me 100 rupees. You can see the leaves are quite thick, I told you earlier, but there is a white speckles of silver shades. So the next variety is also a variety of Hoya. This plant is known as Hoya clover. Its leaves are also very waxy like Hoya carnosa, but the leaf size is quite very small. And you can see that this plant is really doing very well. You can see that there are so many growth. So the propagation of Hoyas are very simple also. Just take the 2 to 3 inch of cutting and place it in a water or in soil mixture. That's all for today. But before ending this video, I want you to show the Philodendron micans new leaves and its growth. Like my videos if you like them. Unlike my videos, if you don't like them, and comment down below that why you don't like my videos, and also subscribe to my channel to know more about houseplants. Love you guys. Bye.